you don't have any sales, and you think you're the victim here, you're selfish or you're lazy. That's it. You're too focused on yourself, or you haven't even taken the time to figure out what your customers really want, which means you're lazy. So which one is it? You want to grow sales? You want to stop wasting marketing dollars? You better figure out what your customers really want. Do you know how many times we're working through a brief and we hit the point where I don't even know what it is we're selling? Sure, you have a service, you have a product, you have features, you have benefits. No one's buying that. You know that old cliche saying, no one buys a drill to have a drill, they really want holes? You gotta ask yourself, you gotta do the work. What are people really buying? And you don't do the work. You don't know. You don't spend enough time with your customers. You don't spend enough time with your clients. You're not doing any market research. You don't really know what it is people want. And so your marketing is vanilla. It's safe. It tries to speak to everyone. And it doesn't work. When we're taking a product to market, when we're working on a brand, or when we're trying to start a campaign, the question I ask is, what are we really selling? Let's say you're a charity. You're not selling anything, you're trying to get donations. So are you selling hope? Are you selling the feeling of involvement? Are you selling that these kids will be helped? You run a recycling company. What are you selling back to them? A greener planet? You run a marketing agency, like us. Are we selling websites? Are we selling videos? Are we selling more leads? Are we selling growing your business? What are you actually selling? This doesn't start with you. This starts with the customer. This starts with the people who want to buy from you. You have to stop looking at yourself and you have to start looking at your customers. Who are they? What are their real motivations? What are they really buying? What do they really fear? If you don't know your customers, if you don't know who they are or anything about them, how could you possibly try and connect with them? How could you possibly try and get in front of them and not only win over their hearts, but also their minds? And you don't know your customers. You don't know what they want. So when you sit down to create your marketing campaign, you play it completely safe. You're not tapping into anything that anyone cares about. Or worse, you're copying everyone else. You're looking at what everyone else is doing. So it's you copying a bunch of other people who are copying a bunch of other people. You guys all look the same. And guess what? You're all missing the mark. And then what happens is one lone person figures this out. They focus on it. They do a really great thing. They break through. And everyone says, where did this person come from? How are they doing it? So they start copying. But they're not copying for the right reasons. Listen, I don't really think that you're that lazy. They work their asses off for this stuff. They just don't realize how important it is. Are they too selfish? Are you too selfish? Yeah, you're very focused on the things you want to talk about. No one lines up to listen to the things that you want to talk about. If your customers have a question, are you answering it? If they have a feeling, are you tapping into it? If they have a fear, are you addressing that fear? If they have security or safety issues, are you making them feel at peace? Think about these things. Are you doing any of these things? And so when it comes to your marketing, when it comes to your sales, you have to think about the customer and what it is they want. We all fall in this trap. We're really scared that people are gonna judge us, that they're gonna come along and think that we're not good enough. They're gonna compare us to someone else and they're gonna say, you suck. This other person is amazing. And so it's from this place of fear. It's from this place of safety and security that you're trying to create your campaigns. And the safe and secure campaigns do not break through. They don't go anywhere. They don't make any emotional connection at all. They don't alleviate any of the fears or any of the things that your customers are striving towards. Okay, so you find yourself, your sales suck. Your marketing isn't working. You're wasting your dollars. What do you do with this? How do you proceed? Where do you go? The first thing you need to do is take a really hard look at yourself. Look at what you're doing. Look at what you're saying. Look at how you're communicating, marketing, and speaking, and actually come to terms with the fact that you suck at this. You're gonna get defensive. You came to what you have for smart reasons in your mind, but you missed the mark. You have to be willing to blow everything up and stop being you focused and start being client focused. Next, you have to spend time talking to your customers. If you are leading the company and you are not on the front line, if you're not working with customers, if you're not speaking to customers, if you're not having them demo your product in front of you, if you're not willing to ask them what sucks about what you have, if you don't know the good and the bad, if you don't know the real reasons people buy from you, your marketing will always be garbage. It will be vanilla, it will be soft, you will actually never know. And so the easiest way to do this is to just talk to people. Just talk to them. Ask them. If you're a service-based business, take people out for coffees. If you sell a product online, really look at the customer reviews and ask people to give you specific customer reviews, just private reviews. If you're launching a new product, test it, not with your family, not with your friends, not with the people who are your biggest fans. Test it with regular people. Ask for the holes in your thinking. Ask why you're not as good as you think you are. You have to find out as much as you can about the customer, because people will not be honest with you. They will be very polite. They will be very kind. They will tell you what they think you want to hear. They will not be honest. Next, take all of these things that you've learned, put them into a bullet point, and really scrutinize every single point. What you are looking for, what you are digging into, what you are hoping you will find is a point that is uniquely you. So most of the time what we see is someone will come up with a list of 10 or 15 or 20 things that they think, oh, these are the things that make me me. But if you take away your name, if you take away your industry, and you just apply them to anybody at all, they're completely generic. Great, you put customers first, everyone does. You're award winning, who cares? You save people time and money, awesome. Yeah, that's great, everybody does that. The one that everyone talks about now, you're Bluetooth enabled, you're a smart device, you're a wearable. Like seriously, who cares? You have to start crossing the things off your list that anybody can say in any industry. You're an accounting firm and you say you're professional, who cares? Every accounting firm should be professional. You shouldn't be in business if you weren't professional. Start crossing off the stuff that anyone can say in any industry. Now here's the point where you're gonna get really scared, because you're gonna start crossing things off. You're gonna find yourself with only three things left, with two things left. If you find yourself with nothing, now you've hit the real point here. You do not actually have anything unique about your business, and that should terrify you. So what do you do with this? You just went through, you listed 18, 20 things that you thought were awesome. You start crossing them off the list. If you're lucky, you have one or two things. Amazing. But most people find themselves with nothing. And this is where the real work actually begins. Because now you realize that everyone in the industry talks the same way, and you've just wasted years talking the same way. Now you can actually create something that is unique, client-focused, and is gonna connect. Now you have the opportunity to create something that is unignorable. You don't care if people see you and choose to look away or not, but you need to get to a position where you cannot be ignored. So let me give you a real world example. Jason, camera guy here, he comes with me to Evan Carmichael's event, and we're sitting down and we're talking about his LinkedIn profile. And Jason's profile is like, it's pretty professional. It sounds great. He talks about who he is, the type of work he's done, the clients he's worked with, big companies that you would know, and then at the very bottom, buried deep within, is this like little one-liner about his purpose. Evan destroys him. Evan destroys you, Jason. Because that little purpose, that little one-liner on the purpose shouldn't be buried in the bottom. It should be the thing you lead with. And everything else in there sounds exactly like everyone else. And I understand, Jason, like you are a freelancer. You need to hustle. You need to connect. You want to be perceived as professional. You want to be just as good as everyone else. People aren't buying you because you know how to operate a camera. They're not working with you because you're just a nice guy. You are like next level at taking their vision and making it happen. You are prompt. You are professional. You have an amazing eye. So great, anyone can operate a camera. Anyone can do all that technical stuff. But when you work with Jason, what you get is not only someone who wants to do social change and share great stories and provide perspectives for those who are not able to speak for themselves, you get someone who's gonna make your vision a reality, you get someone who's really prompt and listens well and is thoughtful, and you got someone with a great eye. Now, if he understood his customers, and if he was bold enough to actually write that down, he would lead with that. He's not gonna sound like everyone else. This is basic stuff, but either you know you should do this and you're just too lazy, you don't care, you really don't care, or you're selfish. You're thinking about yourself. You wanna tell people what you wanna tell people. You don't even take the time to think about what they want. If you were buying someone a birthday gift that you truly loved, would you go out and would you buy a birthday gift that made you look awesome knowing that they don't care and they hated it? Or would you go out of your way to make sure that that gift you give them not only shows your thoughtfulness, but is perfect for them? The act of giving the gift is about giving them something that you know they would cherish and love. That amount of energy, that amount of thought, that amount of planning and thinking has to go into your marketing, your sales, what you say, and who you are. So when you do this right, you are the gift. You are the present. You are helping them overcome their challenges. You are making it easier for them. You are taking care of everything for them. You are the gift. You have everything you need to start this process today. And when you do it, When you put the effort in, people are going to start to fall in love with you. Your sales leads are going to rise. People are going to connect better with your brand. You're going to start crushing the competition. And in a year, your wasted dollars will decrease. Your profits will increase. Focusing on this thing will literally change your business. It will take your business from where you are today to the place that you want to be. But you have to start today. That one I felt.
I felt that one.
If growing and scaling your business by being better at sales and better at marketing, better at customer experience is important to you, be sure to check out this video right over here. And like always, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon, and get each video every day when it drops.